This is the city. My name's Springfield, Rick Springfield, and I carry a badge.
This is the sidewalk. The name's Case, just in case. I'm using my badge as a paperweight back at the office.
We've been assigned to investigate a series of drug deals that have disrupted the binge drinking and late night study sessions of one quiet college town. 9:45, no activity.
I grew weary of waiting for our contact to show up and thought I'd take an evening stroll. It was dark that night. Too dark.
Hey, Case, it looks like our contact.
Well, our contact looks an awful lot like a car.
You got the stuff?
Well, this would go great with some hashish.
So where's the money? Hey, it was nice to do a business with you guys.
And we're not finished yet.
I'm Detective Springfield. This is my partner, Inspector Case. You're under arrest.
Oh, shit.
All right, go.
You know, you should tell him that before we give him all our money. I can't believe it. I know. All the taste, none of the fat.
No, Case, that was Captain Neal, our boss.
Wow. He's working late.
You know, I hope possessing the knowledge our captain's a criminal doesn't hurt our relationship with him. Or our employment.
Well, we can't arrest him, Case. He's the captain. Figurehead. Imagine how it'd make our department look.
But with or without the drive-thru window. Captain Tenille, you look a little different.
New haircut?
Are you always so amusing?
Only before 5. After that, I'm charming.
I'm Rick Springfield. This is my partner, just in case.
Nice names. Cool parents?
Good morning, Captain Tenille. Is that a new shirt?
Shut up, Case. Nobody likes a sucker. This is a bad shirt. I hate this shirt.
Good morning, Captain. That's a crappy shirt. The real crappy shirt.
Shut up, Springfield. No one likes you.
I like it.
Thanks, man.
Where's last night's report?
It's right here, sir.
Who's Rhonda?
Oh, must be my bad.
It says here that you saw the driver, but you did not move to apprehend.
Yes, sir.
Was he armed?
Heavily. You know, he might respond if you take your dress off.
If you don't mind me asking, sir, where were you around 10 p.m. last night?
Duh, it was Wednesday night. I was at home with my wife watching Deep Space Nine reruns.
Someone married you?
What's that supposed to mean? You think I don't have feelings? You think I don't care? You think I don't cry inside every time some officer makes some offhand remark in this department?
Well, yeah.
You're the hard-ass police captain.
I'm the smart-ass loose cannon who plays by his own set of rules.
I'm the brilliant straight guy who does everything by the book.
Sorry, it was a straight guy. It made me laugh.
Get out!
And this poor woman, desperately trying to get your attention, is the token love interest. Well, for me.
It's sort of expected.
I want you to stake out that green again tonight. And this time, shoot anything that moves.
We can do that?
So, where are the donuts?
Who the hell are you?
Food. She found his weakness.
Demeanor. Karen demeanor.
Misdemeanor. Cute.
Misdemeanor? As in the former head of the DEA?
Misdemeanors in Miss July 1996? That was one of my favorite issues. I want to thank you, from the bottom of my heart, for getting me through some really, really hard times.
I've been brought in to help you with your current problem.
But the pills really do seem to be working.
And my doctor says it'll look just like real hair.
The drug problem, sir. It seems that your department hasn't made successful busts since 1994.
Oh, right.
Yeah. The drug thing.
That's right, man. We solve mysteries for a living.
Springfield case, I want you to work closely with Miss Demeanor. She may be able to introduce you to some new techniques that you haven't considered.
I hope so.
Oh, Karen. Miss Demeanor. I want to apologize for not introducing you to Captain Tennille, but, well, I didn't know who you were.
Yes, and I was too busy checking you out.
I'm starting to see why I was called in. You guys need all the help you can get. I'm gonna go bring the car around. I suppose you should come with me.
Your car's outside! You know I think she likes me. I really do. She's playing hard to get, which is okay, because at least this one doesn't have a restraining order.
But she's right, Case. We are a net. That hood from last night is still on the street, and all we did was give up early and order Chinese takeout.
Come on, don't feel so bad, man. Every year, thousands of criminals go unpunished due to the inept laziness of a dysfunctional and easily distracted police force. What, was that a quarter? You know, I think Captain Tennille was lying about where he was last night.
Why would he do that? He's our captain, a role model of what a good cop should be.
Hey, is that Captain Tennille hitting on Misdemeanor?
Oh, God.
I think I got an idea.
Yeah, me too. After all, she said she was 18.
Why don't you go with Misdemeanor, try to find out who's behind this whole drug thing?
I like your thinking. What do you do?
Get a doctor's appointment.
Yeah, the captain's right. We never would have thought of that.
No.
Doctor, doctor, give me the news. I got a bad case of loving you. Oh.
Harper, it's good to see you again.
Detective, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Has the swelling gone down?
I was hoping you could tell me.
Oh, well, come on in. You can turn your head and cough.
Thank you.
Excellent. Have a seat.
Thank you.
What can I do for you, Detective?
You've been Captain Tennille's physician for a long time, isn't that correct?
Yeah, it's quite an intriguing case. I think I just found his heart.
Interesting. Has he been on any special medication lately because he's so fat?
Well, I keep him on a strict regimen of costly pills to control his blood flow.
And he takes these daily?
I'm bound by the doctor-patient privilege not to tell you things like that. I'll tell you for $50.
What would happen if he were to, say miss a dose?
Insanity would ensue as the blood slowly closed off from the brain. Memory loss, blackouts, eventual death. Anything else that's convenient for the plot.
I'm telling you, man, I don't know anything.
All right, see that woman over there? I'm really trying to impress her, so anything you could do would just be really great.
Oh, she's hot. Is that Miss July?
Yeah, I think so. Look, can't you give me something?
I think I've got herpes.
Detective Sprinkle, it's about time you got here.
What's he doing?
We need to know who's supplying drugs to half the metropolitan area. The case is well versed in the art of fake radiation.
Is he flicking that guy's ear? That hood doesn't stand a chance. Ow, all right. The guy you want is Mr. Fuzzy. He lives in an abandoned warehouse downtown.
What about that fat guy that was driving with him? What's he up to?
I don't know, about 225 or so.
That's pretty good. But seriously though, what were you doing with him?
Well, he broke into the same house I was at last night, 422 Park Place. Now, I was looking for some money. He was looking for food. And I asked him if he could drive me over to the garage for a bag of chips, and he said yes.
That's very good. You did very well.
I don't think he's getting anything out of that guy.
Despite what you might think of Inspector Case, he's a good guy. He'll get the job done.
I admire your devotion to your partner, Detective, but we'll never get anywhere with that sex-crazed idiot.
Ow! Oh, and then when I was 5, I knocked some old guy out of his wheelchair, and I rode it down the slippy slide at the rec center.
That was a terrible, terrible, awful thing you did, you know, but it sounds like fun.
Justin.
Yes, Mr. Meaden?
Let me try something.
Oh, it's about time. Oh.
You know, you're kind of handsome for a criminal.
Yeah, I get that a lot. It's the hair. Most hoods don't take the time to properly rinse.
Oh, it shows.
What the hell is she doing?
Well, she's talking dirty to the suspects. Which is alright, but you already told me everything we need to know.
Couldn't we, tell her?
No, let her talk. This is the longest I've been able to look at her without her slapping me.
Deserted warehouse on the outskirts of town.
Yeah, who'd have thought? Good job, misdemeanor. I never thought he'd crack.
So, what's the plan? So, you don't have a plan? You don't have a plan?
Well, usually the captain lays it out in the good old Etch-a-Sketch for us. But he's been missing his heart pills lately, so...
Yeah. Hey, wait. I think I got an idea. I mean, it's kind of dangerous, you know, but it is functional.
This isn't another pickup line, is it?
All right, that's it. I know you think I'm sexist and the rudest guy on the planet, but you make me nervous, all right? I mean, all I can do when I'm around you is make jokes and these little sarcastic defensive quips because I can't think of a good way to tell you I think you're the most beautiful person I've ever met in my entire life. And I've met a lot of people, so there you go.
That was so beautiful.
That's another line, isn't it?
Ah,
You got me. I'm a pig.
So, what's this amazing plan of yours?
Hey, hi. I'm walking around your neighborhood bothering people. What are you doing in my warehouse? What's up with this pizza? You got about 2 seconds to get out of here before I start kicking your ass.
That doesn't sound right.
Look, it says here on the slip, Mr. Fuzzy,
yeah,
big spooky warehouse, one large pizza with extra cheese.
Extra cheese, huh? Actually, that does sound pretty good.
What do I owe you? Well, you know, how about just a little bit of the white label? You know, the smack, the special dust.
Come again?
I'll just take some drugs. We'll call it even.
Oh, drugs.
Wait right here.
Yeah.
Anything else?
Yeah.
Hey, that's not pizza. Good.
Hold it right there, Dr. Pepper.
So, you saw through my disguise. At last you know the awful truth.
Wait, it tastes more like diet?
If you were the one behind it all along, then why did you help me cure the captain?
What can I say? I'm a giver.
This is the worst bust ever.
Well, not from where I'm standing.
I mean, you're under arrest.
Well, could be worse.
Why did you have to go and say that?
Sure, Captain, show yourself around. I plan on making a few long-distance calls myself.
Case, misdemeanor. Wait right here. I gotta get some from the car.
Thanks for the backup, Ulrich.
Hey, you're looking a little shaky there, Chief.
Take care of things.
Is that concerning your voice, Karen?
You have a gun pointed at your head, and you're hitting on yourself.
Have you seen you?
Captain Tennille, why are you doing this?
Captain Tennille had nothing to do with it. I was the one who replaced his heart medication with Flintstone's vitamins, causing him to go insane and do my bidding for all the food he could eat. And you almost brought him another pizza.
Thanks for the confession. Would you be willing to put that down on paper?
Yeah, I'm starting to rethink this plan.
With the police captain under your control, you could get away with murder.
Oh, I think I'm about to.
Hey, is this about that married remark? I mean, I didn't really mean anything by it, unless you thought I was surprised beyond belief that a living human female would consent to marrying such a fat, bloated, incomprehensible pig like yourself. You don't have kids, do you?
Case, get down!
Well, hey, that's new.
Where am I? What are you two doing here? What's 10 plus 4?
The jig is up, Mr. Fuzzy. It's all over.
The jig is up?
Oh man, does that mean I cannot sleep here anymore?
Ha! See that? We're not inept and lazy.
Well, if I remember correctly, it was misdemeanor who let him get away last time.
Isn't that the villain escaping through the door you all left open?
Freeze, police! Pretend I'm aiming a gun right now.
Well, I'll do better than that.
Hey, I'll go help her. You stay here and read the guy's rights so we don't get sued again. Karen, look out! Damn. You know, it never really looks this painful in the movies.
I'm sorry, Inspector Case. I was wrong about you. You do care about the people.
Aw, crap. I think I'm heading towards a bright light. Yeah, there it is.
The bullet never hit a misdemeanor. It ricocheted off the wall and broke a shot glass in the other room.
Thanks, man.
My shot glass? Bastard!
What do you think this is, a disposable pencil?
Oh, okay, all right, yeah, I faked it for attention, yes I did, but I did dive in front of you.
See, you can reload it.
Don't I get anything for that? Thanks!
Damn it.
Oh, okay, you're upset, I get that, but... If I don't mean anything to you, then why are you mad? Oh.
So we figure, Captain Tennille, that you missed a few doses of your medication, causing you to go temporarily insane.
Yeah, but instead of shooting people from a bell tower, you went in search of food. Because you're such a fat, disgusting pig. Who's married.
And thanks to Detective Springfield's heroic pursuit.
I'm the only one laughing.
Jackass.
Okay. Stop, boys.
Jar lady.
And thanks to Detective Springfield's heroic pursuit, we have Mr. Fuzzy in our possession. The man who switched your medication in the first place, hoping to bring you under his control and wreak havoc on the city.
Well done, all of you. The drug deals have miraculously stopped and the students are back to studying too little and drinking too much.
Luckily, no one was hurt.
Yeah, not without a certain lack of trying, Mr. Triggerhead.
Sorry about that, Case. You look like a Twinkie.
Well, there's one more I hope I never hear again.
It's been great working with you, Mr. Maynard. You've been a hero of mine since my academy days.
Yeah, mine too. You and pages 45 through 56.
It's been nice working with you too. Maybe we can do it again sometime.
I hope so. I mean, we seem to get at least one big case every week. Usually the same night and time, too.
I'm gonna keep that in mind.
Karen, wait. I meant what I said earlier. You know, about you being pretty and me being a big fan of that. Oh, sure. Walk away. See if I care. But you'll regret it. And maybe not today. Maybe not tomorrow. Maybe not even after Wednesday when you realize there's nothing good on TV. But when you get married, squeeze out a few babies, balloon up and get dumped by your husband only to find comfort in the arms of a blind alien race, and make the cover of the Weekly World News for the picture of you and your alien love child, you'll come crawling back to me. And when you do, I'll say, what the hell?
See you around.
So what's next? Another big bust?
A shootout?
A stakeout?
A cookout. It's my wife's birthday this Saturday, and I wanted to grill up some hot dogs, you know, for me.
How sweet.
We'll get right on that, sir.
You know, I really like that shirt.
Shut up, Case. No one likes a smartass.
Hey, you know that feeling you get when you just love your job?
I guess.
What's that like?